love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Here we are at the third Sunday of Advent. Christmas is getting closer. We began our Advent journey by lighting the candle of hope on the first Sunday, followed by the candle of peace last week. The flames from these candles invite us to wonder, dream, pray, and reflect. We do all of those things, remembering that we can bring God's hope and peace into the world today. Today we light the next candle of Advent, the candle of joy, and the candle reminds us that this is a season to celebrate God's goodness. We light this third candle of Advent, the candle of joy, as an invitation for us to praise God with generous voice and action, especially in these days. Let every voice proclaim that joy. Thanks be to God. Please be seated. And you're invited to come along as Catherine sings hymn number 6, Candles Burning, the first 3 verses. God of impending light, we rejoice in your compassion for us. You send us your light and your healing love that we might become better representatives of you in this world, which cries for justice and peace and hope. Be with us this morning. We gather to hear your word for us. And as we gather this day, we open our hearts to you, seeking your healing and transforming love. As our world cries for justice for all, heal and teach us the ways of hope and joy and peace. And be with us and prepare us for the bright light of love which you are sending. For we ask this in Christ's own name. Speak to us, O God. Help us to hear your voice as we together pray the prayer that Jesus taught us, listening to the words, the music. welcome to all of you who have gathered here physically today, and also to those who are joining electronically also through your own device on Facebook or YouTube or the church website. We celebrate God's mysterious ways, especially during this season. Yes, we are limited by legislation to no more than 25 people physically in the worship space, but through technology, many more are able to be blessed, and the religious needs of others are met in this way also. I have a few announcements, and I'll draw your attention to some of those. There are opportunities to bring in non-perishable goods. There are baskets here at the church as people come into the sanctuary. You can put those items in there at any time, and we will make sure that they get where they need to go. There are also, today, we are sharing in a service that uses music primarily, Carols and Lessons Sunday, it is often referred to as. And today we thank Catherine Calderon-Collard for being our cantor, and she and Judy are together providing music for us during the service, and we're grateful to them both for sharing their gifts and talents during this time. Financial update is available at the back of the sanctuary. You're invited to look there, and we thank our donors for their continued commitment to our church and to our community. Also, the Christmas Bazaar was online this year. I know that, I believe, there are baked goods that are available to you this Sunday after church. So please, if there are things that you want to purchase for your family to eat, go down and see the ladies down, I suppose, in the kitchen area down there. A few other things. If you have a specific prayer request, please send the first names only. God knows the needs and also our full names, but we will pray with you if you email those names. It's helpful for me if they come before Wednesday, but we will do our best whenever they come to pray with you during the service. Coffee hours will continue if we are locked down completely. At this point, we're not, but we hear threats and such may come, and you'll just watch your email, and you will find out things, or watch the church website, and adjust as you are able. The Remembering Tree is up this year. Some of you saw pictures of it on Facebook and in other places. And if you would take a look at the names you provided, if there are any names that are missing, I'm terribly sorry. Please just update me and make me aware, and we'll put out another incarnation of the list. So please take a look and make sure that the names that you sent are there and have the right proper color of light and so on with them. Other things, M&S White Gift Sunday is next Sunday. So some of you have an envelope inside your envelope box for M&S White Gift Sunday. Bring that next Sunday. That's when those gifts will be received. Next Sunday is also Sunday School Pageant Sunday, and the children have worked with Catherine and Lynn putting together a video for you. And we will be observing the video during the service and sharing with the children in that way this year. Very creative response, really, to what we have to work with. And so I'm looking forward to it. I think it'll be a lot of fun. And I'm looking forward to next week, as I know all of you are too. Christmas Eve services. There are two services. One's at 6:30, one is at 8. The 8 o'clock service is nearly full. So if you want to sign up to come, you better do so today. After the service today, any remaining spots will be made available to the community. So please remember to think that through. If you're going to be here, sign up before you leave. There is a spot on sheets at the back table. Please sign up, or you may be disappointed if you were planning on coming. The two services will be exactly the same. You don't have to worry that one will have communion, one will not. They both will not. They will be celebrations of Christmas and Christmas story. But as you know, with restrictions that are in place and rising numbers, things like communion are probably not the best choice for us right now. We hold each other in prayer, and love each other dearly, and we make sure that each other's safety is paramount. One of the two services will be streamed online, and for those of you who choose to stay at home and feel safer that way, remember that you can go to the church website and other places and also participate in the service that way. I'm just looking to see if there are any other things. December the 27th, the service will be an online service only. We will not be gathering in person on the 27th. Just an online service will be available on the, sounds like I lost, there we go. It's an online service only on the 27th. I will ask, are there any other announcements that need to be made at this time? No one's jumping up and down, nobody's waving furiously, and so without carrying on any longer, we will share now in our offering. Hear these words. God has so richly poured gifts of love, peace, hope, and joy into our lives. So after the offertory music, we will rise as our gifts and our offerings are brought forward and dedicated in prayer and blessing. story for the children. Before I begin, children, I would like you to think about what would happen if your friends just didn't trust you. What would happen if they didn't like what you did? What would happen if they questioned the reasons for doing it? Well, something like that happened to Sandy. You see, Sandy had a really big heart. She always went out of her way to help others. And this Christmas, she decided that she would start a clothing drive at her school for people who needed clothes and couldn't afford them for themselves. Her teacher loved the idea, but the principal did not. It took a conference with her parents, the principal, and the teacher so that she could start collecting clothes. Some of her fellow classmates loved the idea and pitched in to help immediately. But some of her friends, just like the principal, wondered why she wanted to collect clothes anyway. And they peppered her with questions. "Why are you wasting your time?" one girl asked. "You just want the attention, don't you?" complained another. "You think you're a big shot, don't you?" a third chimed in. To all of the questions, Sandy answered, "No. No, collecting clothes is not a waste of time. No, I don't want the attention. I just want to help other people who need something. No, I'm not a big shot. I'm just a girl like you." But her friends sometimes gave Sandy looks that clearly said what they were thinking. "We don't believe you," they seemed to say. Sandy felt kind of lonely. She told her friends the truth, and none of them believed her. But you know, that didn't stop her from her project. She wanted to help. Not to make herself look good, but because there were people who were cold. On the last day of the drive, Sandy was busy arranging the clothes into piles. Trucks had arrived to take the clothes to the missions downtown. And suddenly the principal and a woman walked up to Sandy. "Sandy," the principal said, "I'd like you to meet Miss Johnson. She's the director of the mission." "Thank you for the clothes," Ms. Johnson said. "Your efforts made a difference this year. You know, it's such a hard year. This COVID virus thing has made things so much more difficult for people. And people really are in need," she said. You know, that's all that Sandy wanted to hear. She made a difference. No matter what the principal or her friends might have said, she made a difference. One part of the Christmas and Advent season remembers the work of someone named John the Baptist. We hear about his work during this season, which is called Advent. He was a force for justice and peace, and I believe for light. And so, remembering that, it's time to put another light out for us to look at. We have other lights here. I think there's one more down here somewhere. Oh, there, it's way over there. Yes. Another one. We hear about his work. This person was a force of justice and peace in his world. And like Sandy, John was questioned about why he was doing what he was doing. Did John think he was baptizing people and preaching for no reason? Did he think he was someone important? No, John wanted to prepare people for Jesus' arrival. Like Sandy, he was there to serve and to make a difference. So as you're sitting and as you're listening to the rest of the service, I want you to think about this. How could you make a difference for others? How could you make life better, say, for your parents, or for your brother or sister or your best friend? What could you do to make a difference? You think about that as we hear the music, Once in Royal David City. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." And she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This is the first registration was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth, lying in a manger."
suddenly there was
with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told.
That's the Christmas story.
Join with me as we say thank you to Judy, Catherine, for leading us in worship through music this day. Let us continue to worship God as we pray together. Let us pray. It is true, O God, the first Christmas was pretty simple. Remind us that it's okay if ours is simple too. Bring hope, bring joy, bring peace to our hearts, O God. Bring your healing love into Help us to be those who will bring justice into the lives of those around us. We have gathered here today to sing our joyful praises to you, to celebrate the fast approaching coming of the Christ child, to learn ways of justice, peace, hope, and joy for all people. It is just over a week until families and friends will gather for Christmas during this strange COVID year. And yet, there are people who live in hopelessness, untouched by your peace, weighed down by joyless burdens that they feel. There is darkness that is difficult to live in and to overcome. But you have called us to this. Empower our hearts and our spirits to be strong witnesses of your presence in our lives. Lay your healing hands on all those who struggle with health issues at this time. Pray for Malcolm, for Elaine, Carol, and Rita, and countless others. We also lift to you those who are grieving over the loss of loved ones. Those who have lost people recently, through the pandemic, and even before any of that ever hit. So many are feeling grief deeply this year. Will God dance with those people who have found your love and power in your living, and who are involving themselves in ministries of justice, hope, peace, and joy. Be with us all and prepare us to celebrate the birth of your Son in new ways this year. We pray this in the name of Christ. Amen. Allow the final hymn, "A Little Town of Bethlehem," to speak to your hearts and minds and spirits.
Oh.
are able, please rise to receive the benediction. God of the watching ones, the waiting ones, the slow and suffering ones, the angels in heaven, the child in the womb, give us your benediction, your good word for our souls, that we might rest and rise in the kindness of your company. Go now with the blessings of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.